Hey, what's good, tubers? None of the nerd here, and oh, shit! What? Oh, I seem to have a rant in my pants. A multitude of rants in my pants. Would you like to come? All right. You know what I've never been understand for the life of me? The American citizens who idolize and like are deeply engaged in following the British royal family. Like, I mean, I don't want to like, you know, spoil anything for you here, but there was like a war not too long ago. Well, it was a long time ago.
A war that we fucking won, by the way.
I don't want to suck the dick of the Founding Fathers too hard here. I mean, one, they've been dead for like hundreds of years. But two, you know, Not the best people on the planet, you know, owning other people as property. Look, I do think that some of the revolutionary values they held were particularly progressive, especially for their time. And one of those values that I hold near and dear to my own heart is the abolishment that we did of the British caste system. We have no landed gentry, no nobility, and most especially, no royalty.
Ostensibly.
What? And yeah, so what kills me is that these people aren't British citizens, and yet they worship the British monarchy. But here's the thing, even if you are British, the monarchy doesn't really make any sense. And quite frankly, all of the arguments for a monarchy are fucking terrible. Like, oh, well, you know, we get some tourism, dollars coming in for people to see and marvel at the king and queen and all their, you know, fucking fancy clothes and shit.
Well, la-dee-da!
La-dee-da!
The problem is that the royal family is actually a net drain on the UK economy. I mean, there's other arguments and stuff, of course, like, oh, well, it gives us a sense of national identity and unity, which is, I mean, just a crazy, stupid, pseudoscientific appeal to emotion. I mean, I think national identity is pretty fucking cringe, to be honest. And you can get a sense of national unity from things other than a weird, backwards, magical bloodline bullshit.
You're old Harry, wizard.
There's also the argument that monarchies bring stability, which I don't actually see being the case. And even if that it was, you know, the case, stability isn't necessarily a good thing. I've also heard that they're like a nonpartisan or apolitical head of state. And I mean, one, do we necessarily have to have a head of state?
Say now, that's dangerous thinking, Paul. You best stick to your work.
But also, I mean, let's be very clear here. They're not apolitical. I mean, while their political interests may be outside of the current mainstream, they're inherently political position. And of course, they're going to want to push the nation in directions that favor their interests. I mean, that's just, it's only logical. And I think all of this kind of misses the larger point of what the monarchy actually is. I mean, setting aside, of course, all of the crazy magic bullshit about, oh, well, you know, their God-given rights to magically rule with their crazy bloodline, you know, Keke Genkai bullshit.
None.
But what are they actually? They're parasites leeching off society. I mean, people talk about welfare queens, but there's literally no bigger welfare queen on the planet, maybe even in all of human existence, than Queen Elizabeth. They're people who are born a higher class of person who literally have more rights than other people. Now, the whole bloodline aspect of monarchies also creates a lot of incest inbreeding type shit, which, I mean, that's no good for anybody.
Speak for yourself.
Like with other types of ruling classes, like the billionaire ruling class we have in America, seems to create an awful lot of pedophiles. Anyway, I mean, following the British royal family, you know, popping in every once in a while on social media and stuff like that, I mean, I don't think that's an inherently a bad thing, but it is kind of weird that that happens, and I think I'm just kind of rambling here.
And all that glitters is gone.